Okay, so I'm trying again. Trying to see if I got it straightened out. I increased my bitrate that I'm streaming. It looks better so far. So, let's see here. Back to where I was. Okay, so I now have some science to spend. What do I want to get? Really don't want, need micro rocket. Let's see here. Bigger tank. Oh. General field ducts would be nice. Only buy one thing. Well, here. What I said before. Science first. Except I don't see any science research stuff. Ladders could be nice. Ooh, there. Pressure barometer. There we go. Look at that. That'll give us some ladder. That'll let me do a new thing for my rocket. Let's see here. Actually, how much would it cost to upgrade this? Go ahead. Why not? I don't really want to ferry people yet. I don't think. Too much. Apparently no repairs are needed. My little drop-offs must have missed. Okay, let's go in here and see what we can do. Now, I really don't see what parts we have. Let's see. Have a bigger. Darn near tiny. Don't have any bigger. Right, that's a jet engine. That's not really gonna help us. Get rid of that, because that was stupid. Now. Gonna take this off, make sure it's still at 2.65. I can add more to it. I don't know that I really want to add too much more to it, you know, but 3.1, that's better. Better. Go ahead and add another tank. Okay, 1.8. I do want to add some upper aerodynamics to it. Just to keep it in line with the bottom, I'll do 4. I would have done 3, but I'll go with 4. Actually, let's go to 3. I got an idea how to fix the bottom part. Okay, so there we have that. Okay, we still have positive. Well, these are gone. Okay, I do think I want to separate that. Not sure I'm a big fan of exploding stuff right on the rocket. Okay. Going to change a few, one thing up here, or two things maybe. I know this seems odd to put it here, but whatever. I'll also forevermore have batters. That'll allow me, if I land on land, I can go down and get soil samples and stuff. Okay, now this is going to be the true test to see if my stream's grainy or not. See what comes up. Hello. Okay. Is my stream working? Let me refresh my this. It's still a little grainy for my likes. Not sure what's going on there. But it is better. Okay. I'm actually going to kill all thrust on the main. I'll keep it actually a little, just for control purposes. Because this is going to be a little insane, because we have, it's basically 3.0 on the thrust to weight ratio from these guys. But those working nicely, having the fins on it, or winglets. Gonna start kicking it up. I want to start tilting this over. But roughly, that's probably a good angle for now. Start getting it this is actually gonna work out pretty good here. Yeah. Hold it now at this angle, roughly. You know, I start when I'm just tilting it, sliding it over more and more, so that way I can get into orbit. Okay. I'm gonna hold it right here and push. Hopefully. Yeah, we still have a positive thrust to weight ratio. That's one of the things I wanted to check. Right now we're looking at about 30 kilometers we're going to get to. We might hit that 45 kilometer mark for that heat shield. We won't have to worry about it again. Let's tilt this a little more. Apparently we're pushing just a hair too fast. Slow it down a little. Want to keep it still pushing fast enough, hard enough that we keep a positive thrust to weight ratio going. And actually, once we see it, our apoapsis hits 100 kilometers, I'm going to actually kill the engine completely. Looks like we're doing pretty good here. Okay, we're positive. I'm going to tell it to go prograde. Once we get close to the 102 kilometer mark, good. Okay, we deleted all those. Awesome. Rocco Max and decoupler. Apparently I need to do that sometime. A suborbital trajectory at 240 kilometers. Okay, we're coming up on our 100 kilometers for apoapsis. This is where I'm going to actually trigger and do some science. Apparently I've already done science up here. Okay. I should have grabbed the barometric pressure reader. Oh well. Okay, so here we go. Coming up on the 102. We want to get as close to the apoapsis, then I'm going to kick on the engine at full. That will then help push the periapsis up and around. Going to kick it right when it hits 100. Okay. Now, the apoapsis is still going up some, but we are now in orbit. I don't know if we triggered that. Orbit Kerbin. I'll wait until I get closer to the 155. I'll push the periapsis up higher. Just going to do a quick time acceleration so I can get to the 155 quicker. Got 6 minutes to cut down on time. I don't really want to wait 6 minutes real life, you know, so. Okay. 3 minutes. 2 minutes. 1. Okay. 40 seconds. Let this go ahead and go back to the prograde. let it get down to roughly 10 seconds, and I'll start a burn. I don't know that I'll do a full throttle. I'll just accelerate up the engines. Just looking to push the periapsis up above. I don't know if I really want to do that now. Okay, well, fine. Let's see. The crew report. Fine, whatever. EVA. Let go. EVA report. Grab back on. Back in there. Okay. Let's see. I have now. Like I said, I don't want to burn too hard, too high, or too now, because I just noticed that I have, I'm almost out of fuel. I really do need to conserve the fuel. I will likely, I'll let this go around and hopefully get that orbit achievement. It will slow me down because it is the upper atmosphere that I will be sliding through. But once I hit the apoapsis the next time around, I will then do a deceleration burn to push the periapsis below, and so that way I can start slamming into the atmosphere. Okay, let's see what happens. Hopefully, I won't lose too much on my apoapsis. Yeah. Let's see here. Stream still looks a little grainy. Like I said, it does look better. Kind of wish I could get it to look like what I'm seeing. So that way, yeah, you know, just look nice. Wonder if I can change the buffer. Because if I increase my buffer, it might help too. Still got a minute and a half to periapsis. I'm doing the physics acceleration to try to get through it quicker. So far, really not dropping too much on the apoapsis. It's probably a good thing. We are dropping a little bit on the periapsis though too. But it's still above 61K, so it's not really that big of a deal. At least not yet. Okay. Now we're going back up. Let's see if we've trying to get the goal of reach, achieve goal, orbit Kerbin. I've gone around. I don't know if I've gone around once enough or something, you know. It may be I have to hit like a certain altitude on both apoapsis, periapsis. So I could have probably have done it on this one if I had actually not gotten to the 150 kilometer on the apoapsis, if I would have balanced it a little bit better. So now I'm just gonna, like I said, wait a little bit. Hopefully once I get to the apoapsis again, even though it's gonna be much lower, I'll do my retrograde burn to drop my periapsis down so that way I'll hit the atmosphere more next time. No matter what, I'm in a decaying orbit anyway, so it doesn't matter. I will eventually deorbit. Okay. Really don't need the Kerbal Alarm Clock. Now apparently Kerbal Alarm Clock also has an update. I think it'll tell me here somewhere. Da-da-da. I don't know. Maybe it'll, I know I saw it one of the times. I have 3.4.0.0, which means there's probably a minor upgrade or update to fix maybe a minor bug or something. They're always working on it, keeping it up to date. So, and like I said, when you start flying like multiple rockets, it makes it a lot easier to be able to switch because you know when to switch. You don't have to worry about writing down some time or something like that and trying to jump over in time. Okay, now I'm waiting to get to the apoapsis down, and I'll do my retrograde burn. Okay. I'm just going to do a full throttle burn. Once I get to roughly zero. And the way I'm kicking this engine up like this, if you don't know, is the Z button. Z will put your engine at full throttle. Yep, and that was all I had. Z and X. Z does full throttle, X does down to zero. Yep, so I'm going to go ahead and jettison the lower stage. Really don't need it anymore. This way it'll drift off and be far enough away on re-entry it shouldn't collide into me. And apparently, like I said, I didn't achieve the orbit goal, which I would assume means I would have to have both of them above like 70 kilometers. And time accelerate. As you see, it's sliding off. Now, because I got rid of it where I did, it may not actually burn up. It may not just disappear. I may have to fly it until it gets disintegrated. Because it's now far enough away that physics isn't affecting it technically, nor is heating and stuff like that, so having this massive heat shield on here will is overkill, but I did achieve the goal of testing it out, so. Kind of wish that you get more science while doing a deorbit, like, because technically things are going to be completely different at different altitudes, whether you're from going up versus while you're deorbiting. So, like, you know, heat's definitely going to be different. So you would think, and that would also change some of the results in your other tests. Now, I know you typically wouldn't want to really be doing science in while you're deorbiting, you know, going through the atmosphere. But, you know, just a thought. I don't know where I'm probably going to end up coming down. Probably in the desert. That'd be my guess. Either that or I'll be out in this ocean. If I'm on the ground in the desert or something, I will be able to easily. Yeah, if I land on the ground, I'll be able to get a sample. But if not, not a huge deal. And as you can tell, the heat shield is heating up. But nothing else is. Now, this will actually keep all my parts on the sides and outside safe. Not that I really had a big issue with that before. I might actually end up doing another round around the planet. Or another orbit around the planet, because it all depends on how much I lose this time around. 45 kilometers typically is the, once you hit that, you're not coming back. Well, I may not be coming back. Okay, well, we'll find out here in a second. We are definitely not going to go back up. Well, we might go up, but we won't be going back. We, you know, it's going to be constantly down from here. Or, well, we're not going to come out of the atmosphere. If you look at the Apple app, says it's now at 90K. It's going to easily slide below the 60 kilometers. So, I don't think we have the velocity to go back up. Actually, we're done. This is coming in pretty good. We're at 38 kilometers and, well, the periapsis is at 37 kilometers and going down, so. With the apoapsis being at 75 kilometers, 73, 72, yeah, it's just dropping too fast. There's no way we're gonna get back out of this. Not that we wanted to, We really don't have a rocket left to do anything. I kind of wish my setup had a way that I could have a mute button on my mixer. That way I could just toggle that and be done. Yep, there we go. We're now, yeah, there's, just, even though it says the apoapsis is still 54 kilometers, there's no way you're going to go from 7 kilometers in altitude back up. Not without any kind of thrust to get you there. So this is a nice gentle ease back into the atmosphere. We will likely, I don't know that we're going to hit that desert. We might land in the crater area. Let's see here. Due to our velocity, it could be interesting. We're going to miss the ocean completely. We're going to probably land somewhere around in here. As long as we clear those mountains, which could be good, bad, who knows? We'll find out. And yeah, if you didn't know, if you look at this is really a crater. You got a nice big circular event here. Only in the center is there something. So I would assume that there was like some crater impact that made, I guess, everybody extinct, the Kerbals. Considering there's no life on the planet except for the Kerbals. Technically, there's nothing even around the planet other than at your little place that you launch. Let's see what happens if I do this. Oh, whatever. What about temperature? I'll keep it. That's data. A decent amount of data. Okay. So, yeah, we're easily clearing the mountains. That's probably a good thing, because you don't want to be too low where you might clip them, but, you know, at a high speed. Yeah. So far, I look like I'm roughly right. I'm staying right about, I think, here-ish. I'm hoping that's true, because that's another mountainish area. I don't really want to land in it. It kind of makes things complicated. But it isn't as bad as, say, landing on this mountain range or in this one. We can kind of see we're pointed straight at that there up ahead. Right now it doesn't really look like much, since the way the terrain is. But, yeah. Okay, we're starting to slow down. We were probably going to land in the green. Somewhere between... I only say that because... now we're... just coasting. Ooh, 0.7 science. And there we go. Down we go. Now, because I have the ladder on, I can go down and try to take a soil sample and do all kinds of stuff like that. Now, just to wait until we land. Land. Yeah. More. Go ahead and turn off that. We don't really need any kind of controls. We got parachutes going. It'll eventually put the retrograde underneath us, but you know, whatever. Still, it's so grainy. I wish I could get that fixed. I'll do some more research and figure out what's going on. Try to get a little less grain going on. We are well above sea level. Well, well above sea level. Buffer may actually help also the drop frames. Good way to tell how close you are actually to land is to look for your shadow. You can kind of get an idea, a better idea, on how close you are to actually landing. Because, you know, it's kind of, without objects and stuff, you can't get a real good sense on how close you are. And without, you know, some kind of point of reference, the shadow is a definitely great point of reference. Fairly close. If you look, the shadow, well, just disappeared. It's changing between a close shadow and a far shadow. Basically. So we're getting pretty close. It's slowly growing to the size of the what we have. So could be very soon. Go ahead and there we go. We are down. EVA. Go ahead and climb down. Go. Here, surface sample, get some more science. Could plant a flag, but I really don't care to. Do some science here because it's not where I've been before. It's a little more. I think I've gotten all the others used up, so I know I won't get much for a second capsule, but might as well use it since I've got it. Okay, now I can do a recover and get the science back. Okay, in here, let's see. Don't really care about miniaturization. This could be useful. Inline stabilizer, a lander can. So it's basically a one Kerbal, like you can make a, the idea, I think, was to make something that you similar to the moon landers that the U.S. used back in the space race and when Apollo and all that, all the different Apollo missions. Lander legs, not really a big need for them yet. think this one's the most useful. I only say that because it gives more fuel tanks.
Aha!
Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and stop the stream here and see if I can tinker with my setup a little more. I don't know that I'll be back for streaming more, but you know, I just want to see about fixing some of this so that way I have a better stream for everybody.